Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And if you was watching yesterday's video, I believe you could predict what kind of tank we are going to play today. Aka Object 416 Bucket. But skill, it's more likely frying pan. Shit, in Lithuania we have a weird buckets, okay? What can I say? So, I want to highlight a very, very good things about this vehicle. What is this vehicle? What is this medium tank? It's not truly a medium tank. It's not like T-44 you are going in front by saying whoa, 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 and banging everyone. It's not the case. With this vehicle, you need to be super duper hyper turbo passive, okay? You need to be a bushwanker a bit and everything. And the main highlight of this tank is very, very simple. The main highlight is the gun. What is so damn unique about the gun here, fellas? 320 alpha damage in the tier 8 is humongously good, okay? Some tier 10s have the alpha damage of this. Penetration with a standard 201, which is half of the treble, but this is not where this tank is shining. Heat penetration with this vehicle is 330. It is very, very, very strong and very, very good, okay? It is very, very, very nice. And you're meeting tanks like Mouse, E100, you will shred them like a hot knife through the butter. And that's where this tank is shining. For equipment, I decided to go for this kind of setup. I decided to go for ventilation rammer optics, and the main reason why I went for that, not for stabilizer, as an example, replace ventilation for stabilizer, I decided to not do so. And the main reason, once again, why? Because you are sitting in the back line either way majority of the times. And now very, very important thing also to say, camo of this vehicle. Watch this. 46% camo stationary. This is humongous camo. As an example, compare that to T-44-100, it is 35. So yeah, it is... This vehicle have something to offer, my friends. Believe me, it does. So, without further ado, let's start the journey and we will play two to three games. We'll see how the things will go and we will try to make this vehicle work. In the worst case scenario with this tank, you can be as a light tank. And currently we are having a losing spawn in fjords, right? Which is not very, very good thing, but we will make it work. And skill, how we are going to make it work. As you can see, there is no light tanks whatsoever, which is very good thing for us. Why so? Because we are going to take the position. We are going to take the position right here, fellas. Whoop, right here. And we will try to bang everyone which is playing around this area and which is playing here and maybe which is playing here, right? It's very, very important thing. And honestly, I think it is one of the most underrated tanks in the tier 8, right? It's not ideal vehicle, believe me, it's not the best tank in the world of tanks, but holy bananas from Banana Land, it can work. It can work. I remember when Bucket was, I think, what Wargaming failed to do, fellas, as wrong as it sounds. They wanted to make their guard something like a Bucket aka Object 416 frying pan, or however you are calling this vehicle, right? But they simply failed doing so. At least that's what I want to believe. So, this is the position where we want to play, fellas. This is the position where we want to play. Beautiful. That's what we have. We are in the bush. Now we are going to spot people which is playing here. We are going to spot people which is playing here and so on, so on. So all we need to do, we need to calm down a bit and we need to wait until enemies will get banged. And if you would pay... Oh, kurva. If you would pay attention at the test simply got slaughtered. He got murdered, he forgot his name, he forgot where he is from, and he is completely banged. I don't really think I will get spotted here, so I'm not even bothering to move from here. And once again, we are just chilling, we are enjoying ourselves, and we are waiting until enemies will make one or another bad move. That's all it matters for us, fellas. As you can see, we have quite a bit of the tanks here, which is getting farmed by the CS-63. And CS-63 is currently living the dream because once again he is banging literally everyone which is playing here. So keep this in mind. unfortunate for our team, but hey, what can we do? And in the same time, they have a 3 bloody guns here, so obviously this is very, very, very complicated situation for our team. And obviously our guys cannot go on the full Trollolo mode here, because if they will do that, it's going to be quite bad ending. So once again, whenever you are playing with a bucket, you need to have the mentality of the tank destroyer. Skill with the flying, if that's supposed to mean. That's supposed to mean be patient. Don't rush too much, especially against the tier 10s. There is no point for you to go on the full. It's just simply not worth it. It is just simply not worth it, my friends. It is not worth it. So once again, wait a bit. I am very, very well aware of this CS63, which is farming our guys here, okay? I'm super duper hyper turbo aware of that. And STB is banging the everyone which is sitting here. And we are losing the heavy line. But once again, our main and initial plan is to deal with people which is about to approach us from here. That's the most important part for us, fellas. That's the most important part for us. Also, you know what? I am actually thinking about loading heat immediately. Skill, what do you mean loading heat immediately? Wow, this guy lost his turret. Well, actually, he doesn't have turret. Doesn't matter. He lost everything what he had, right? And here we go. This is exactly what we are looking for. We are looking for someone to make a bit of pressure like this. And now we are going to bang the Jack Tiger from behind, right? This is exactly what we want. Here you go. 3000 assisting damage just like this. Boom! This is what I'm talking about, and this is what we want to see, fellas. This is exactly what we want to see, my friends, truly. Okay, I'm checking, do we have the right angle here? And by the looks of it, we do. It is completely fine. Obviously, like I mentioned before, this is a losing spawn, so do not expect to do too much here. And in the same time, you can say whatever flying F you want. I would say we are carrying our weight, right? Being a bottom tier tank, I think it is completely fine what we are doing here. Once again, we cannot take any beating whatsoever, but what we can do, we can attempt to punish enemies every single time whenever they are making something silly, right? That's all we care about, and that's all we want to see. This guy, boom, one for the team. Nice. Even though we are taking one here, it doesn't really matter, because it is in a way the game over already. So in a way, you know, it's, we are not going to get much more use from all this. And once again, we cannot blame ourselves too much. I think our play was quite close to perfection, my lovely friends. Honestly, I would say our game was quite close to perfection. Beautiful. What do we have here? We have the CS, which is thinking about making a bit of pressure, and he did. Beautiful. So what happened exactly right here, and skill, why this is a losing spawn? I said that multiple times, and I can repeat that once again. Enemies took this, enemies took this, enemies took this. They have a massive crossfire over field, and they managed to win this. So in a way, this is a four position crossfire towards this, especially when you are losing this, right? Although you could have a safe defense parameter over there, but once again, it's not about this. It is completely fine. As a first game, fellas, we did everything ideally. We did everything well, and I am very, very, very happy with this performance. It's just proving the point this tank can behave like a spotter in certain situations, right? Finish it on top. Nice. Badger farmed the heavy line, I assume. STB farmed the very, very important position in the middle, which is mini lake or something. He was using his gun depression, which is completely understandable. And here you go. This is the whole situation. But I'm still feeling happy. I'm still feeling good. And let's go for the other game. Don't you think so? Let's go. And what do we have here? We have a glacier against the tier 7s. This is actually a very, very nice map. Since we have a bloody full camo, I believe we could go and play into the middle. There is only one Jeff, which is always nice and always welcome. And the question is, can we actually punish the heavy tanks, which is crossing towards the Bravo line through the middle? I think what I want to do, I want to take this middle position here. I think it should work well. And once again, in this game, since we are a top tiers, and once again, the matchmaking is looking quite well for us, we don't need to snipe from the back, right? We can always return back to the for a base defense or something. So keep this in mind. keep this in mind. Okay, what is the plan? There is two light tanks which can try to go up here, but to be fair with you, I don't really mind them that much. I don't really mind them that much, my friends. Beautiful. We are about to enter the position where we want to be, or reach the position where we want to be, and here we go. We are in the right position. Holy fucking F. You know what is the most annoying thing for me here? The most annoying thing for me, my lovely friends, is the bloody sun, which is pretty much shining in the face, right? That's the most annoying thing. Ay, that's very bad. In the same time, you can see, whenever you are not using the stabilizer, it can be quite complicated situation, right? In a way, I believe you would agree with me. You don't have a stabilizer, and hitting the not fully aimed shots, it's not so nice. But once again, very, very well deserved, and I know what I am paying for not using the stabilizer itself, right? So once again, I cannot complain about this too much. Now Tiger 1. Wow. Tiger 1 is sniping from here. Soon, fellas, we will need to figure out what is the right play for us not to get slaughtered, right? Maybe hitting this TVP Wato could be an idea. I'm spotted all the time by the looks of it. Okay, fair enough. That's the start. We have 1,400 damage in the... Well, 1,400 combined, I suppose to say, in the first 2 minutes of the battle. Once again, I'm feeling quite well here, and I think I crafted another idea how we can make some pain for the enemy team. Skill how we can make some pain for the enemy team. We are going into the middle here, and from the middle, we will try to spot the HTC, and we will try to spot someone here, right? It doesn't really matter. Here we go. Beautiful. This is exactly what we want to see, my friends. Exactly what we want to see. We want to be annoying spotter schnitzels for our team, right? Because we can afford this, and HTC is actually having a very, very nice angle here. Beautiful. I'm surprised how he outspotted us that easily. I am surprised how the flying F he outspotted us that easy. Okay, wait for it. Like I said, wait for it, fellas. Like I said, wait for it. Arta is sitting right here. Unfortunately, I don't really have a chance to do anything for him. Losing HP left, right, and center. Definitely not what we want to do, but it happens sometimes. Can we hit this guy pretty please? Can we hit this guy pretty please? Aim. Boom. Beautiful hit for Mr. Tiger. Very nice. And once again, all we need to do, we need to have a kind of safe defense parameter here. We have all time in the world of tanks, and we are simply trying to figure out the way how we can punish enemies without getting punished ourselves. We are taking our sweet time to aim, and here we go. We are aiming. Meanwhile, there is a defender which is trying to go on top of the hill, and oh my bananas. Defender on top of the hill. Is it a real life, my lovely friends? Is it a real life? Let's try to go backwards a bit. Boom, in the ass, and unfortunately I did not manage to hit him. Shame. Oh well, it happens, right? Mistakes were made, not much what I can do about this. Now it is about the time, since I am kind of down to one shotable, right? It is about the time to get the flying F out from here. This HTC is punishing me from typical position. Once again, that's completely understandable and completely fine. I could expect that. But in the same time, we still have something inside in our hearts, right? We still can play this battle. No need to give up. I can understand why people do not like this vehicle, because overall it's a tricky tank to play with. The gun depression of this vehicle can be very, very depressing, if you know what I mean. It is just a complicated vehicle to play with, right? But if you will master this vehicle, if you will get yourself into the positions from where you can snipe, then life is going to be bloody-ful. Okay, let's wait until enemies will make one or another mistake. The score is equal, and if our guys will make pressure like this, they will get banged. It's not even debatable, fellas. It is not even debatable. So far we have 2,100 combined already, which is once again not bad score whatsoever, but we want to get a bit more, right? Call me greedy, but we want to get a bit more. Super Hellcat is sniping from the casual bush there. I'm trying to figure out where enemies are, okay? That's what I am trying to do. I am trying to guess where the flying F enemies are. Yeah, go back. A bit more. Not too much. Nice. Beautiful. We have a perfect angle for this guy. Can we hit him once again? Beautiful. We can hit him once again. Now another guy trying to escape. He's down to one shotable. How about if we would eliminate him from the game? He's eliminated. And what we can do against the FAVA? I would love to hit him once again, but honestly, I don't really think it's going to be the case. So what we need to do, we need to actually think about our end game now, right? Because unfortunately, but our team is melting a bit and this is not looking very, very great. Also, one more thing, the Super Hellcat might try to make a pressure for our Sue. Although I need to help this guy. This is very, very, very important thing, fellas. I need to help this guy. I'm going to load hits just in case. And let's see. Do we have a nice angle to hit the FAVA from? Nah, not really. My friends, we do not have the best angle right here. Keep this in mind. Now moving out of the bush, trying to blind fire the Super Hellcat. This is a blind fire because I did not saw the splash. Let's go for another one for the sake of love. Beautiful. Unfortunately, this time I saw the splash, which is not very, very nice. Oh boy. Fava. No, Mother Trucker, your time to shine. Come here. Beautiful. We got this. He should not be able to spot us. Scorpion. Ay. Relax. Fava should go up here. He's not, but Scorpion is pushing in front. We are hitting Scorpion. Scorpion is probably thinking about going on the full Trollolo mode. Scorpion is flanking us. Not much what we can do about this. Fava is right here. That's completely fine. I hope our Jeff is going to get a good angle. I see the Fava going on us on the full Trollolo. Don't worry, I see him. How about let's die for a ram? It's okay. Fellas, I'm not complaining about this performance. I am feeling completely fine. I sacrificed a bit too many HP in the start of the battle, right? That was my initial problem and initial mistake which I have done here. Still, in my opinion, quite great performance. We have solid 3,300 combined. Unfortunately, we are not picking this game up. But once again, I can't complain too much. It happens. Last guy left. And this map is extremely tricky for a heavy tank. Skill, what do you mean it's tricky for a heavy tanks? Well, whenever heavies are winning this side, it doesn't matter you are playing from the east or you are playing from the west, right? It doesn't really matter from where you are playing. Whenever you are winning this, you need to return back. If you will push from this side overall like this, you will get farmed by the bushwankers here. If you are going to make a pressure from this side right here, you will get stuck here. Or if you will make a pressure like this, you will simply die, right? So once again, it happens, it's okay, better luck next time. So, in the end of the day, this is not a bad performance by any means. I could play better, I could save my HP a bit more, but once again, this is the risk which you are taking with a bucket, right? This is the risk which you are taking with a bucket. Next. Actually, we have 2,700 damage and 1,100 assisting damage, and this is bringing us to 3,700. It's actually even better than I initially thought. Did we hit the Super Hellcat twice? We hit the Super Hellcat once. We hit the Super Hellcat once with a blind shot. Nice. Once again, I'm not complaining, fellas. I am thinking this game was quite good and everything went well. Let's go for a third battle. Maybe we will get something very, very good for a sniper schnitzels. And indeed, we do. This is not a bad map. It can be annoying, but overall, it's quite good. And if you would pay attention here, this is very, very important point. There is no light tanks whatsoever, right? What that means when there is no light tanks? If you are playing with the tanks like a bucket, aka Object 416, you can be a light tank yourself. Skill, what do you mean? How dare you? You can be with a sniper schnitzel a light tank. The thing is, fellas, tanks like UDES, Object 416 have two roles. When there is no light tanks, you can actually behave like a spotter schnitzel. And this is mainly how I played with this vehicle, if I remember that correctly. When I had a chance to spot, I was spotting. When I had a chance to do damage, obviously I'm doing damage, right? And usually you are trying not to be aggressive unless all stars are aligned for you. By saying all stars are aligned for you, well, imagine that. You are playing against the tier 6 shitters, enemy tier 8 tanks is in the other side, so maybe you can make a pressure towards the side which is weaker, right? Simple as this. Let's see. Speed of this vehicle is completely fine. I mean, 50 kilometers per hour, it's not bad whatsoever. Okay, are we going to get into position? That's the question. Going like this, going like this, going like this. Almost in position, trying to turn around. Skill, why you are turning around? Well, answer is extremely simple why we are turning around. Because we are preparing for escape already. But skill, what do you mean we are preparing for escape? The thing is, whenever enemies will make pressure like this, whenever we will spot them making pressure like this, we will shoot and brrr away from here. That's the most important thing. And as you can see, since there is no light tanks, enemies are being quite aggressive here, you know? And we have 1,300 assisting damage. We are... Fellas, one very, very, very important part is, in order to be useful part of the team, you don't necessarily need to do only damage, right? You can actually be useful by spotting for your team. And once again, that's very, very, very important part of all this. And now we are running away from here. Skill, why we are running away from here? Because there is a Type 59 which is making a hardcore pressure like this. So it is about the time to simply say bye-bye. I had enough. Thank you very much, fellas. I had a blast. I hope you had a blast too. Now gun. GG. Finito. Trashante is here. He is thinking who the flying F is spotting me. And I am already out of the position. He cannot do shit for me. And I am feeling quite happy. Now, next, what do we want to do here? We want to take this red line over there. I usually don't use this position, but it can work just fine. What we are going to do meanwhile? Meanwhile, we are going to knock those trees down over there, right? That's quite straightforward. Tree, boom, down. Very, very nice. Another trees over there, fellas. Once again, we are building our nest for ourselves. I am pretty much, behaving like a pigeon right here, but beautiful pigeon. Not a simple one, fellas. Not the one which is shitting on the other people head. I am the one which is only peaceful one and trying to build the nest. That's all I do. And here we go. We have a perfect position right here. And we are saying zdaro for Trashante. Trashante is thinking, oh my bananas. Where the flying F you are? And I'm saying, yep, sue me. Sue me, mother trucker. That's what I am saying. Exactly what I need, fellas. So once again, we are moving in front of the bush. We are waiting until enemies will make one or another pressure here. And whenever they will do a pressure, we are immediately going to smack them in the head. Obviously, I'm using all benefits which this vehicle is giving. Aka Yeet 330 millimeters of penetration, which is humongous and which is very, very, very strong, right? By the way, this position can be useful for pretty much any medium tank, any tank destroyer, right? This position is golden if you are using it properly and correctly, my lovely friends. Too bad we are not going through the Object 430, but once again, that's quite well deserved. This guy is thinking about peeking here. If he is going to do that, we will eliminate him from the game. And here we go. This guy is dead. Beautiful. What to do now? That's the question. Once again, patience is the key. I was thinking about shooting standards, but it's not worth it. Hits all the way through. hits all the way through. As you can see, this position, whenever you are using the bush mechanics and everything, knocking down the trees, blah, 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 it is a big fat pain in the ass for the enemies. And once again, that's all we need from this position. We don't need anything else, just to stop the enemies, just to annoy the enemies, and to say Zdarov. Remember me, I am a medium tank which have the camo of the light tank. What do you think about me? Do you love me? Love me, please. Love me, please. That's pretty much what we are doing, my friends. Oh, my bananas. I'm getting spotted here. What that means, try to escape like this. Unfortunately, 430 manager to hit us here. But once again, it doesn't really change anything. And I am just trying to be annoying. Soon, fellas, we will try to escape from here overall, right? We are preparing for escaping, and now we are going out from here. Beautiful, this guy is spotted. But you know what? In the same time, I'm not feeling that bad, right? I am not feeling that bad. We managed to hit this guy straight in the face. That's very, very nice. We are trying to hit him once again. Beautiful, we are hitting him once again. Now I'm going to reload faster than this guy will. He doesn't know that, but it's the case. And here you go. This is a game over for us, unless Gusor will save us. I owe a big fat thank you for this guy. And here you go. This is how to be sniper schnitzel bushwanker, and this is a perfection of this vehicle. What we have done here was perfect. I honestly cannot say a single bad thing. What we skill you spam at gold, fellas. It's the same thing like you are trying to ride with a bicycle without wheels, right? Like you are carrying the bicycle instead of riding it. This is the case with this vehicle. This tank have two features to offer. Extremely good camo, aka you can be like a light tank, and you have extremely good penetration with a gold ammunition. If you are not using those two things, I mean, what the flying F you are doing? And I completely understand there is quite a bit of people which is against the gold ammunition and so on. I respect you, fellas. And if you are looking for from this kind of perspective and from this side, then this vehicle is definitely not for you, right? And I want to be honest, my lovely friends. I don't have any thoughts about lying for you. Why would I do that? Why would I do that, my friends? Beautiful. Excellent battle, very, very nice game. 2,200 damage, 2,200 assisting damage, and as you can see, it was perfection. So for a person which said skill, do a bucket video, here you go. And I noticed that, buddy, you were stock, but every single tank is stock whenever you are starting. So whenever you will grind through that, remember to use your boosters and everything. And this is the situation, this is the score which you can have. So in the end of the day, 2,200 damage, 2,500 assisting damage. We are somewhere on the top, not by the damage, but overall by experience. Obviously, our model won in first place, which is completely fine. Probably he was fighting in the close quarters and in the close distance, right? So in the end of the day, what we have in the bucket, we have solid 2,200 damage, and we have 2,300 assisting damage, which is bringing us to 4,500 combined. Call me dirty, but I think it is perfect performance with this vehicle. So with all respect, uno momento. I can't wait to get the comment from your side, Prom. Nice. It was very, very nice to see you in the battlefield yesterday, right? And I hope it's going to make your grind just a bit better, my lovely friend. Thank you very much for watching, fellas. That was your daily dose of skill, and skill is out. Peace.